long time ago, lived a man named Joe, who was reverent and righteous, turning from sin. He had many children, cattle and servants. Indeed, he was richer than all other men. Now there came a time when the angels of God went to present themselves there at his throne. The devil was also among them that day, and he stood before God just like one of his own. Have you considered Job, said the Lord, a man who is blameless in word and in deed? None on the earth can be likened to him. Whatever is righteous, he's anxious to heed. Well, of course the man's faithful and obedient to you. He's just playing the game because you do what you do. You've put up a hedge round his house and his lands. You've been blessing his flocks in every work of his hands. He's like all the rest of this rabble today. He gives loyal service to the one who will pay. But take away all of those things that you gave, and he'll curse you till the day that he goes to his grave. Then the devil went out, took all of Job's riches, and he killed all his children in an instant of time. Job tore his robes, but he worshipped the Lord. And Job did not sin or curse God for this crime. Again came a time when the angels of God went to present themselves there at his throne. The devil was also among them that day, and he stood before God just like one of his own. Have you considered Job, said the Lord, even though without reason you've brought him so low? Still he is faithful, he's righteous and blameless. For all of your evil, there's nothing to show. Well, of course he's been quiet and he's holding his tongue. A man would give all he owns to escape being hung. But if you'll just let me lay his body to waste, the veneer will come off and he'll spit in your face. Satan went out, and he struck Job with sores from his head to his feet. He had boils on his skin until even his wife shrieked at Job and said, why don't you just give it up? Go on, curse God and die. But Job sat in ashes, alone with his pain, and wished for the day when he'd go to the dead. And though covered in misery, he still held his peace and committed no sin in the words that he said.